Disclaimer, you're about to watch somebody critique a show intended for children. I understand that from the viewpoint of the target audience that these issues are not necessarily issues, but for optimum enjoyment of the following video, please follow the upcoming instructions. In the event that you cannot take criticism towards the children's series, please take a break from watching this video and lie down on the floor on your stomach with your hands behind your back and remain until further instructions may be given. This is asked out of the safety of all the involved personnel within this project. I do not take criticism in the form of YouTube comments, and all complaints must be sent to a brick and mortar location, to which will be filed and responded to within 13 to 27 weeks. Postage will be paid by embassy. If condition persists, consider physician, subject to change of address. Time approximate. One size fits all. Colors may in time fade. For office use only. Edit for television. This was current at time printing. At participating locations only. Keep away from fire or flame. Avoid contact. Skin. Sanitize for your protection. Employees and their families are not eligible. Beware of dog. Limited time offer. No purchase necessary. Not recommended for children under 12. Pre-recorded for this time zone. Freshest if eaten before date of carton. Subject to change of address. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. Not responsible for direct, indirect, or incidental or consequential damages resulting from any defect, error, or failure to perform. Slippery when wet. Substantial penalty for early withdrawal. For recreational use only. No Canadian coins. List each check separately by bank number. This is not an offer to sell securities.
Thank God that's over with. Ash is no longer. You hear the news? Of course you did. You're watching this video. There's no way you would be clicking on this video if you didn't know this fact. Ash is no longer the protagonist in the Pokémon series. Starting in 2023, that torch was passed, Pokémon Horizons, featuring a brand new cast and story. I'm going to give a short little review on my thoughts on this show. When I'm halfway through, I'll give my thoughts, and then again, when I'm done with the show, I could word that better. Let me make that sound more fancy. I'm going to be reviewing this show. When I'm halfway through, I'll be giving my critiques, and when I'm at the end, I'll be giving my complete thoughts. Okay, let's go. Okay, so at this point, I've watched episodes 1 through 6. I'll start by quickly mentioning the art and animation. For some reason, I was expecting some huge leap forward from the previous series in terms of quality. Looking back, I'm not exactly sure why, but it's not different. The art style and animation quality very much feel in line with standard modern Pokemon anime. Not bad at all, but not on the same level as like Paldean Winds or that YouTube short about that girl with the Nidoran. You should check it out if you haven't seen that. It's really fun. But my very first impressions of Horizons were really positive. I really enjoyed episodes 1 through 3. This series focuses on a girl named Liko who traveled to the Kanto region to go to school. She later finds out that some evil organization is after her necklace, which has magic powers, and since the necklace is useless without Liko, they're after her as well. She runs away from school and joins this group of adventurers, pirates, in their airship to escape the grasp of this evil group, as well as discover what this necklace is all about. It's a cool premise for a Pokemon show. It has a lot of potential to lead to some great and captivating stories. I've said before that Pokemon has amazing potential for cool storytelling, and it's such a shame that they limit themselves so much in whatever media form they're in. But when I was watching the first few episodes of this series, I legitimately felt like Pokemon was finally reaching its untapped potential. I was captivated by the series' opening, and was very excited to see where it went. Something I want to say real quick is that this show has a very different feel so far. How do I describe this? It feels more grounded in reality. I don't want to say that it's dark or mature, because it's not, nor does it need to be, but there is a layer of realism in the way that characters act and talk that just wasn't in the previous series. It's not easy for me to describe, but I can certainly feel it when I watch it. I can give examples. In the first episode near the end, an evil organization man is at the lobby of Liko's school and gets permission to visit her. He then gives her a letter claiming it was from her grandmother, and Liko, in her internal monologue, is immediately suspicious and brings up how a stranger gave her a letter from somebody who never sends letters. So, on her feet, she quickly claims to go grab her stuff, entering her dorm and then leaving through her window. Later, when Freed is taking her to the airship after saving her life, she freaks out on the inside, and she doesn't know who any of these people are, or what's happening, or where she's going. There are multiple instances of her trying to stand her ground and get straight answers about the scenario at hand, and it's in a way that feels much more realistic and relatable than the previous Pokemon shows. She reacts to things in a more human-like way than Ash has in like 24 years.
I need answers. Excuse me.
Hold that thought, kid. Looks like we got incoming guests. I think it's them.
Now, these examples might not sound like much, and it really isn't that much, but for Pokemon, this hasn't been seen in decades. I love the crew on the airship. First off, I just love airships. Considering my Final Fantasy and Skies of Arcadia-filled RPG heart hole. But yeah, the crew is great. I love a large and varied cast, and this delivers. There's Captain Freed, the captain, he's my favorite, plus Captain Pikachu. They're just awesome. He's definitely my favorite of the group. Orla the mechanic, Murdoch the cook, and Liko the child.
Wait, am I forgetting anyone?
Nah. Okay. As for Liko, I like her a lot. There's a point early on in the show where she hears people on the bus talking about something that she really likes, but she doesn't have the guts to actually speak up and talk to them about it and, you know, make friends.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
Very reserved. She has an inner monologue, and she thinks to herself a lot. A lot more than I was expecting. It's not often that she speaks what's on her mind out loud. Having a main character that's suspicious, smart, anxious, and reserved is honestly a breath of fresh air compared to the very loud and outgoing Ash from the previous series. I'm sorry that I keep comparing this to the other series, but come on, how could I not? Speaking of which, let's talk about my problems with the previous Pokemon series. That trope, friendship. Ash proclaims that he battles to make friends. The more recent shows feature loud, overindulgent, goofy, and silly behaviors. Childlike, in other sense. I know it's a kid's show, but bear with me. Characters often don't know the obvious or are overexpressive. I get that these are complaints for a lot of anime, but it's a problem that prevents me from enjoying the series. That was made past the year 2000. The old show, I'm talking like the 90s, it worked for me because it didn't take itself seriously most of the time. It tried to be funny. The writing wasn't corporate or stale. They were allowed to be a little loose and have fun with it. The story, characters, and occurrences all had a unique quirk that was lost around the time Johto ended and Hoenn started, returning occasionally, yet sparingly. Do you know that feeling of, why am I watching this? You know, you see a kid's show do something embarrassing, like have a dance sequence, cringy applause, power of friendship, childish jokes. That feeling when you're a 19-year-old watching a kid's show at 3 a.m. and you think to yourself, why am I watching this? Well, the Pokemon anime is full of that. But I didn't feel that a single time while watching Pokemon Horizons, up until a certain someone reared their head. Okay, here's a picture of Ash. Okay, we're gonna place him right here. Roy is Ash. Take everything I hate about modern Ash, Control-C, Control-V, that's Roy. He talks like him, he behaves like him, he acts like him, he literally taught his Fui Coco how to ember while they sang horribly in unison. I know, it's supposed to be silly, it's a kid's show, but I got whiplash from the tonal shift I got from the first three episodes to this one.
I don't know why I believe in you! Go! Go! Fui Coco!
I just about had to go to the ER. You can't star like this and then nosedive into this. Roy is not the central focus, thank God. He is a sorry, I keep cracking my knuckles. Roy is not the central focus, thank God. He is a secondary character, just like the rest of the crew, from what I could tell so far. Fingers crossed. But man, what an outlier of the group. I hope he isn't too distracting. Try not to let him ruin it for me. The concept of this ragtag gang exploring the world on their airship, solving mysteries and looking for treasure is awesome, and I hope that the remainder of the show gives me what I'm looking for, but I'm really worried about the future of this series because of Roy, and I'm not exaggerating. I really think he has the potential to ruin this whole thing for me. I feel like his inclusion is such a huge step backwards compared to all the other steps this series took forward, but I'll be back to you when I'm done with the rest of the series. Okay, I've finished season one. Right off the bat, I want to say Roy is a lot more tolerable when he's not the sole focus of the episode, like he was around episodes 4 through 6. Due to the size of the cast, he didn't play that large of a role, especially compared to Liko, so that's good. Unfortunately, something else popped up. I'll get to it later. Spoilers, by the way. Episode 7 was okay, I guess. It was a filler episode where Roy and Leo train with Cap. We were also introduced to a new crew member named Dot, though we didn't see her. Episode 8. Now, this is how you do filler, in my opinion. This is an episode solely focused on the crew. The Rising Volts, I think they're called? I don't exactly remember. Anyways, Murdoch and Freed are staying up late trying to make pastries for Dot, the shut-in crew member that we never see from the last episode. And during the day, the rest of the crew is like, what's going on? Why is our food supply so short? So they stop at a town to shop, while Liko stays behind to try to get Dot to talk to her. Little note that I forgot to mention. It's literally stated that Dot doesn't eat food. She just eats vitamin gummies once a day.
Does she get nutrition?
Yeah, sort of. She takes gummy vitamins that give her a day's worth.
I thought those were for emergency.
That doesn't sound like shut in. That sounds like mental health issues to me, but you know, whatever. What makes this episode for me is the interactions between the crew. I've mentioned it before, but it's such a joy to just watch the crewmates interact, especially like when they're all around the table during breakfast and just chatting. It's so much fun to just see this group together. It also turns out that Dot is a popular live streamer that multiple characters are seen watching throughout the series. At first I thought the idea was pretty dumb, but then I self-reflected for a bit, and I realized that I literally watch live streams of Pokemon challenge runs and Nuzlocke, so what does that say about me? The crew eventually ended up in Paldea, in a pretty pointless feeling episode where Liko goes home, then decides to keep traveling with the Rising Volts. She battles a pig, so that's cool. In episode 10 and 11 we get an arc, where we get to see Nimona from the video games, a gym fight that Roy loses with a small bit of lore, and a little more banter on the airship. And that's when it dawned on me. This show still uses the standard Pokemon filler formula. A tiny arc, usually spanning over one or two episodes, where the main character meets a new Pokemon, they help it out with whatever problem it has, and then they move on. Miserable. Miserable. I hate miserable. The final dubbed episode so far, episode 12, was actually pretty good. I liked it. Halfway through, Liko's necklace has a JoJo moment, giving her a schizo vision and transforming into this dreidel snail. The rest of the episode is spent setting up the plot for the future, the kids reading up on the history of these ancient Pokeballs and some old legend about heroes and whatever, basic hero's journey stuff, and Professor Freed is talking with Liko's mom about her necklace, and the episode ends with them about to set sail for the Galar region. We have a goal to work towards now. Will the overarching plot finally start? I'm looking forward to finding out. But I don't think that making me excited for season 2 is a good reason to start watching a show. A few closing thoughts. I don't watch anime. Take this with a grain of salt, coming from a big fan of Pokemon and wanting the best of Pokemon. Oh, they got rid of the "Who's that Pokemon?"
Who's that Pokemon?
It's Pikachu!
Yeah, they just have these stills of the characters now. It's kind of weird. I like how Horizons is trying to be more about the people than the actual Pokemon themselves. It takes place in the Pokemon world, but the Pokemon are just that part of the world. They're not front and center taking all the attention like they did in the previous series. The filler-focused, filler-ridden, filler-driven, filler-breathing previous series. I'm sorry, I keep cracking my knuckles. I'm all sorts of distracted right now. When we're focused on the crew and their journey, I'm having a great time. Better than any Pokemon anime that I've ever seen. But when we're not focused on the crew and instead spend an episode helping an olive regrow a forest or something, I'm struggling a bit. Not just a bit, I'm struggling a lot. It's pretty bad. I love Freed a lot. The opening theme is awful, by the way, especially in English. Speaking of which, I'm probably gonna watch in Japanese from now on. Not only is it most likely a better experience, but who knows how long it'll be until it gets dubbed. So as a Pokemon fan, I like this show so far. I love Pokemon though, so that aside, is this a good anime? It's pretty mid. I've heard that it gets better though, so I'll get on that, but still. If you're not into Pokemon, don't watch this. It's not worth it. It's not gonna get you into Pokemon if you're not into Pokemon right now, so don't even bother.